Hi friends, how are you? I am fine. I hope that everyone doing well. I am Ramesh, senior chemistry faculty. In today's session, I am going to discuss the topic mixtures and percentage purity. And mainly, today's class is completely objective class. I want to discuss some important model questions in this topic in NEET and IIT JEE exams. Matter is broadly classified into two types. If we take matter based on presence of impurities, if the matter doesn't contain any impurities, that is said to be pure matter. This is called pure matter. If the matter possesses any impurities, that is said to be impure matter. So matter is broadly classified into two types. One is pure, other one is impure. So pure matter means examples I am telling here, some examples. Elements and compounds. Any element and compounds. These are called pure substances. Examples, sodium, iron, magnesium, these are elements. One more, take the element here, N2 gas is the element, Cl2 gas, and compounds, glucose, water, all these are pure substances. So they cannot be physically separated, that is called pure substances. Impure, the other name for impure substance is called mixtures. The name itself indicates mixture. It is the combination of impure substances or the combination of two, three compounds or two, three elements. For example, here, generally NaCl, in NaCl, the common impurity is MgCl2. So this is the previous AIIMS question. NaCl is generally associated with magnesium chloride. If you take limestone, calcium carbonate, silica is the common impurity. It is always associated, some impurities are always associated with some compounds. Take one more here, best example in our daily life. General rice is, in rice, impurities are there, that are stones. Stones present in the rice, that is common. So these are comes under impure substances and these are comes under pure substances. Impure substances are physically separable, can be separable physically, but they cannot be separable. They cannot be separable. If we take rice and stone, we can physically separate the stones from rice by hand picking method. Okay, this is the matter of classification, pure and impure. Our topic is here impure substances, nothing but mixtures. So take the impure substances. I will take the limestone. So in limestone, impurities are, many impurities are there, dolomite, CaSO4, SiO2, silica, many impurities are there. Okay, when the CaSO3 is associated with SiO2, it is said to be impure CaSO3. This is called impure CaSO3. Okay, this is pure sample and this is called impure sample. So this is pure and this is impure. If you want percentage purity of this impure CaSO3, if you want percentage purity, the weight of pure sample in impure sample by, so total weight into 100. If you want a percentage impurity, then the weight of impurity in impure sample by total weight into 100, total weight into 100. So check the formula here, percentage purity. If you want purity, pure sample weight by total weight into 100. If you want percentage impurity, so mass of impure compound by total weight into 100. So this is the theory class for today's session. Now comes to the different model questions. It is a completely objective part. Again, in questions, I could categorize into three models. First one is easy. Next one is medium level. The latter one is very difficult level. See that one. So this is a easy level. We get the more clarity. What is this percentage purity? How can I calculate from this basic model questions? Easy level questions. What is the percentage purity of sample of CaCO3 if 120 grams of sample gives out 22 grams of CO2 on heating? So 120 grams of CaCO3 upon thermal decomposition gives 22 grams of CO2. First write the CaCO3 thermal decomposition. CaCO3 upon decomposed to form CaO plus CO2 gas. Now see the here they given weight relation. CaCO3 from this equation you get the information is 1 mole of CaCO3 upon decomposition gives 1 mole of CO2. So 1 mole of CaCO3 weight is 100 grams. So molecular mass 100 grams of CaCO3 can produce 1 mole of CO2 means weight is 44 grams of CO2. So 100 grams of CaCO3 can produce 44 grams of CO2. In order to produce 22 grams of CO2, if you take 22 grams of CO2, then how many grams of CaCO3 is required? If you take the cross multiplication, you get the 50 grams. So 50 grams is sufficient in order to produce the 22 grams of CO2. But the question given is 120 grams of CaCO3. So in this 120 grams, only 50 grams of CaCO3 is present. Remaining part is impurity. Now calculate the percentage purity of CaCO3. So percentage purity of CaCO3 equal to, and tell me out of 120 grams, 50 grams only CaCO3 is present. So weight of pure sample by total weight is 120 into 100. That is nearly equal to 41.6%. So this is the basic model. This is the way to calculate the percentage purity. If you want percentage impurity, 100 minus 41.6. Now see the medium level questions. 50 grams of MnO2 on reaction with HCl gives 11.2 liters of Cl2 at NTP. The percentage impurity. See here, they didn't ask the here percentage purity. They are asking percentage impurity. So this is the other way of asking questions. So a different way of asking questions. Instead of asking percentage purity, they are asking percentage impurity of MnO2. Okay, first we want to discuss the equation. The scientist's name is Scheele. He could discover the Cl2 gas through this equation. It is a very important equation in second year pre-black elements. When you pass the HCl vapors and MnO2 solid, HCl, it gives MnCl2 plus Cl2 gas plus and H2O. Now balance this equation. Here 4 Cl's are there. That's why 4 HCl. Now come to the hydrogen here, 2H2. Now the equation is, this is gas and this is liquid and this is aqueous. So now the equation is balanced. So through this equation, Scheele could discover the Cl2 gas. So from this equation, 1 mole of MnO2 can produce 1 mole of Cl2. Here 1 mole of MnO2 can produce 1 mole of Cl2. But the asking question is, they taken MnO2 is weight. One side weight, other side is here volume, 11.2 liters of Cl2. So from this data, we can predict that. So this is like a weight volume relationship. Here one side take the weight. 1 mole of MnO2 molecular mass is manganese is 55, and 2 oxygens weight is 32, so it is total around 87. 87 grams of MnO2 react with HCl to produce how many moles of Cl2 here? 1 mole. 1 mole of Cl2 at HTP occupies how much volume? 22.4. 87 grams of MnO2 can produce 1 mole of Cl2, means 22.4 liters at HTP. Cl2 at HTP. So 87 grams can produce 22.4 liters Cl2. But here, in order to produce the 11.2 liters of Cl2, in order to produce 11.2 liters of Cl2 gas, so how many grams of MnO2 has to react? So this is the question. Now find this one. So exact 11.2 is the exactly half of 22.4. That's why you can expect the weight of MnO2 required to produce the 11.2 also exactly half, 87 by 2, this around 43.5 grams. So this weight of MnO2 is sufficient, but the given weight is 50 grams. So out of 50 grams, then find the, I don't want purity, I want impurities. The weight of impurities, the weight of impurities. So total weight given is 50 grams. So 50 minus the pure MnO2 sample is here, 43.5. The weight is coming around 6.5 grams. So this is the weight of impurities. Now find the percentage impurity. So percentage impurity is equal to weight of impurity by total weight is given is 50 grams into 100. It is nearly 13%. So this is the medium level. Take the one more medium level question. So different way of asking questions. This is, how many grams of 90% pure sodium sulfate can be produced? Sodium sulfate from 250 grams of 95% pure NaCl. So I want to prepare the sodium sulfate from sodium chloride. So that is the question. So first write the equation. How can you produce the sodium sulfate from sodium chloride? So when NaCl react with H2SO4, then it form Na2SO4. So that is our required compound, and HCl. Now balance this equation. Here two sodiums are there, 2 NaCl, and this is 2 HCl. So this is aqueous. It's also aqueous. All are aqueous medium. So now here, so this is the way to produce the Na2SO4. Now come to the data given. So it is said to be 95% pure NaCl. Pure NaCl means 100 grams of this impure sample, 100 grams of sample contains only 95 grams of NaCl. So that is the meaning of 95% pure NaCl. Out of 100 grams of this sample, only 95 grams of NaCl is present. Now here, how many grams of 95% of pure NaCl is present here? 250 grams. So in 100 grams, 95 grams of NaCl is present. Then 250 grams, how much weight of NaCl is present? Then cross multiplication, this is 250 into 95 by 100. That is around nearly equal to 237.5 grams. So this grams of NaCl is present in 250 grams of 95% pure NaCl. So now come to this question. Here 2 moles of NaCl can produce 1 mole of Na2SO4. Okay, each mole NaCl molecular mass is around 58.5 grams. So these grams of NaCl can produce here 1 mole of Na2SO4. Its molecular mass is 142 grams. So this much weight of NaCl can produce 142 grams of Na2SO4. Now, how many grams of NaCl is there here? 237.5. Out of 250, only 237.5 grams of NaCl is present. Now, 237.5 grams of NaCl produce how many grams of Na2SO4? That is 288.25 grams of Na2SO4. So the weight of Na2SO4 produced is the weight of Na2SO4 produced is 288.25 grams. Okay, here, but the Na2SO4 produced is 90% pure. So 90% pure Na2SO4. I want 90% pure Na2SO4. So 90% pure Na2SO4. That the produced 288.25 grams is 100% pure Na2SO4. But I want 90% pure Na2SO4. So 90% pure Na2SO4 means 100 grams of impure sample of Na2SO4 contains only 90 grams of Na2SO4. So with the help of 288.25 grams of Na2SO4, so how many grams of this impure sample can be prepared? That is 320.3 grams of Na2SO4. 90% pure sample can be prepared. So this is a medium level questions. Let us see the difficult level questions. And the question is, 2 grams of pyrolusite ore was treated with 60 centimeter cube of 1 normal oxalic acid and some sulfur in some sulfuric acid. The oxalic acid left undecomposed was raised to 280 centimeter cube in a flask. So 23 centimeter cube of this solution when titrated with 0.1 normal KMnO4 required 36 centimeter cube of the solution. Find the percentage purity of the pyrolusite. Initially, the pyrolusite react with oxalic acid. The unreacted oxalic acid is again back titrated with the KMnO4 solution. So this is the data given. Now there are two reactions here. Initially, pyrolusite react with oxalic acid. Pyrolusite means here Mn. Oxalic acid formula H2C2O4 in presence of sulfuric acid H2SO4. It produces MnSO4 plus CO2 plus H2O. If you check the equation, reactant side here, two carbons are there. Then how many CO2? 2 CO2. Number of hydrogens are here, total 4. That's why it is 2H2O. So after then, the unreacted H2C2O for oxalic acid is titrated with KMnO4. So reaction between H2C2O4 and KMnO4. KMnO4 again in the acidic medium H2SO4. It produces. So when oxalic acid is reacting with KMnO4, the KMnO4 will oxidize oxalic acid to CO2 gas. Initially, it forms K2SO4 plus MnSO4 plus CO2 and H2O. So, if you observe the N factor, oxidation state change in manganese is here plus 7 to, and this is plus 2. So, change is 5. That's why 5H2C2O4, it becomes 10 carbons this side, reactant side, then it is 10 CO2. And here, so two potassiums are there, two KMnO4. Then total here, manganese are two manganese, two Mn. And total SO4s are here, total three. and this is 3H2SO4, then H2O8H2O. So this is the equation between pyrolusite, oxalic acid, and this is oxalic acid and camera. So no need to write this equation. For understanding, I given these two equations. So no need to write these two equations. Based on one point, you can easily solve this question. The gram equivalents of reactants and products, any reactant and product are equal. Number of moles may be vary, but gram equivalents are equal. So here the gram equivalents of oxalic acid is equal to gram equivalents of KMnO4. In order to find the gram equivalents of KMnO4, first we need to find the volume of KMnO4 that can react with oxalic acid. So here, what is the volume given? 23 centimeter cube of oxalic acid requires how much volume of KMnO4 here? 36 centimeter cube of KMnO4. Then here the excess, how much excess is there here? 280 centimeter cube. So 280 centimeter cube of oxalic acid requires how much volume of KMnO4? So here 280 into 36 by 23. That is nearly 420 centimeter cube of KMnO4. So the volume of KMnO4 required in order to react with oxalic acid is 420 centimeter cube. Now the gram equivalents of oxalic acid is equal to gram equivalents of KMnO4. So gram equivalents of KMnO4, normality into volume. So what is the normality of KMnO4 given? That is 0.1. The volume of KMnO4 required for the H2C2O4 is 420. I taken this is centimeter cube, that's why divided with 1000. So this is nearly equal to 0.042. Gram equivalents of oxalic acid that can react with the KMnO4 is 0.042. Okay, now we have to find the initial gram equivalents of oxalic acid taken, means the total or initial total gram equivalents of oxalic acid is how much. So total initial gram equivalents of H2C2O4 initial, so how much volume taken here? 60 centimeter cube. So 60 into volume, normality is 1 by 1000. So that is nearly equal to 0.06. So this is the gram, total gram equivalents of oxalic acid, and this is the gram equivalent unreacted. Then reacted gram equivalents. In this equation, now how many gram equivalents of oxalic acid that can react with MnO2? So gram equivalents of oxalic acid react with pyrolusite MnO2. MnO2 is total minus unreacted. Total is 0.06 minus unreacted here 0.042. So that is nearly equal to 0.018. So from the first equation, the gram equivalents of MnO2 is equal to gram equivalents of oxalic acid. So gram equivalents of MnO2. So gram equivalents of oxalic acid, just now we could find here, this is 0.018. So this is the gram equivalence of MnO2. This is MnO2 gram equivalence. Now find the weight. So gram equivalent weight, gram equivalent formula, weight of MnO2 by equivalent weight. Then weight of MnO2 is equal to 0.018 into equivalent weight of MnO2. So equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight. Manganese 55, two oxygens are total 87 by N factor. N factor in this equation, MnO2 become MnSO4. Here manganese is plus 4, here this is plus 2. So what is the change in oxidation state? This is 2. So here equivalent weight. Then this is nearly equal to 0.783 grams. So initially taken how many grams? This is 2 grams. Out of 2 grams, the weight of MnO2 is pyrolusite is 0.783. Now find the percentage of MnO2, percentage purity or percentage MnO2 is equal to the weight of MnO2 is 0.783 by total weight is initially taken 2 into 100. 39.2%. The percentage purity of pyrolysis is 39.2%. So this is the way to solve this question. That's all for today's session. So try this question from your side. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubts regarding these questions, you can ask in comment session.